The biggest skill gap for a lot of new instructional designers is the technology, learning the actual software that you need to do the job well. And that's why in this video, we'll take a look at the top three tools that you should know if you're a new instructional designer. So the first one, of course, is Articulate Storyline 360. As you probably know by now, it is the most in-demand tool in the industry. It lets you create interactive e-learning experiences, which is what a lot of the demand is for these days. And this tool is a lot like PowerPoint, but it's way more powerful. So people want instructional designers who have this tech skill more than any other tech skill you can think of. And it's actually not that difficult. So we're going to take a look at it together. So this right here is Articulate Storyline. If you're familiar with PowerPoint, you could tell that there's probably a lot of similarities. So, right, you can add pictures, right, from your computer. You could add shapes. You could animate those shapes, right? There's like an animations tab. You can add those animations. So very similar to PowerPoint so far. Where things get different and where I suggest you spend most of your time is learning about triggers. So with this button over here, you can access the trigger wizard and you can take all these different actions. So you can show different layers of the slide. You can change the state of the object, right? Make it a different color, for example. You can even get access to variables if you want to keep track of like the user's score or the user's name and things like that. So definitely study all of these different actions that you can take with triggers and then study when you can trigger them. Right? You can make these actions happen when the user clicks certain things, when certain animations complete, when the timeline reaches a certain point. Because notice we have a timeline down here, just like with video editing tools, right? As soon as this slide starts, then the viewer starts seeing it, this timeline is going to be ticking. So if we didn't want this shape to appear until the 1 second mark, we would drag this out here. So this is, you know, I'm just kind of showing you around in here in case you've never seen this tool before. It sounds maybe more intimidating than it is, but once you've been in here for a week, 2 weeks, a month, you're going to be much more comfortable. You're going to feel much more at home in Articulate Storyline. I have a lot of tutorials on the channel if you're interested in that. The next tool I have for you here is ChatGPT, right? We are in the age of AI now in the instructional design world, so we cannot just ignore this anymore. It's also the easiest way to get started with AI, and it can make your life a whole lot easier, quite significantly easier, right? There's no reason to be working without AI to help you unless your company like completely is against it. So you want to learn how to write some good prompts and you want to organize your chats into projects. I'm going to show you what that looks like. Let me just try to get that background back so that you're not looking at black screen. All right, there we go. And you want to know how to make custom GPT. So we're going to take a look at some of this stuff. So right now, GPT-5 is the latest model available in ChatGPT, and they've posted a whole prompting guide. It might get a little technical, but I do want to point you to this prompt optimizer tool. So right here, we could write a prompt and we could say like, you are an expert instructional designer who will help me write good learning objectives, right? Say that's the prompt that you decided to start with. We could optimize this prompt and basically ChatGPT's prompt optimizer will take all of their best practices and apply it to your prompt for you. So this is its way of rewriting that. So obviously, as your prompts get longer, the suggestions might get better. If you want me to do a whole video on writing optimal prompts, let me know. But yeah, you've probably used ChatGPT by now. Just try to get better with it, right? Here is the projects feature. I use this a lot to help with all different aspects of my business. So you can click on create a new project. You can name it like instructional design assistant, for example. And then you can essentially create a prompt that can guide all of the different chats that you have with this. Where's the settings? They've changed their, here we go, add instructions. That's what we need to do. So we could add these instructions. They changed their user interface a little bit, but we could type in basically a prompt. So you are, we could actually just type in this one we grabbed over here. So then whenever we need to generate learning objectives, right, we have this project saved now. So we would just go over here to the sidebar, click on our instructional design assistant chat, and then we could say, I need 3 learning objectives for an instructional design course. And every new chat now will have those instructions automatically applied to it. So it tries writing those learning objectives. So get comfortable using these projects to keep things organized over here. And then custom GPTs too. These are good for so many reasons. You can use custom GPTs to create e-learning, like role-playing simulations for your learners. You can use them to guide your own behind-the-scenes development work. You can use it to practice role-playing and skills you want to get better with. So they're really powerful. You can go to chatgpt.com/GPTs. I created like a Become an Instructional Designer one that's trained on our whole process to break into the field. So you can use this in a lot of different ways, mock interviews, resume feedback, portfolio feedback. Definitely check that one out. But then you can also create your own with this create button up here. And similar thing, right? You can give it a name like Instructional Design Assistant. You can give it your prompt here. You can also upload knowledge, give conversation starters, and generate a link that you can share with anybody so that anyone can use it. So it's kind of like a public version of the projects we were just talking about. You can share it with your learners. You can share it with your team. You can share it on your portfolio to show off your AI skills. And I just want to mention, I mentioned this in a video recently, but Catherine Schwiebel here created a custom GPT to help people in the healthcare field. So check out this write-up if you'd like. And she just let me know on Tuesday that she landed an AI-powered ID role because of these AI portfolio projects. So definitely a good idea on many fronts to use to get more comfortable using ChatGPT, not just to create projects for your portfolio and your audience, but also to help speed up your workflows and make you a more effective instructional designer in general. And then the third tool I would say that every instructional designer should be familiar with is FreePik. They have a ton of pre-made assets and some really powerful AI tools to generate the media that you need. I also wanted to just shout out this video. If you're interested in the custom GPT thing, we do have a best AI portfolio project video where I go into like exactly how to make it. I give a prompt template, all that good stuff. But this right here is FreePik. So this is like their AI suite overview here, right? Look at all these different tools. You can create AI images, AI characters. I made an AI version of myself. You could see from some of my old generations. So yeah, just check this out, the AI suite, right? You can generate images, video, sound effects, music, voices. You can do lip sync to AI audio. Like there's so much stuff you can do in this tool. It's kind of mind boggling. I'm not going to go into it all here. I'll zoom in a little bit for you so that you can see all of these different tools that are available. And this isn't a new tool, right? This didn't just come out when AI came out. Instructional designers have been using this tool for a long time because of all of their stock assets here. So all of their human created assets. Check it out. We can go to this vectors page here. And right, so many of the e-learning projects that you see online probably have assets coming from this site. Anything you can think of, they're going to have assets for. And if you know some other tools, which we're going to talk to in a little bit for the runner-ups, you can edit these vector images however you want. So you know, a big challenge for a lot of new instructional designers, especially when they're building their portfolio site or trying to create things that look professional, is finding the assets and the graphics. You do not need to create them from scratch. You have tools like FreePik, which will give you pretty much everything you need unless you need something super custom. But now that's why we have the AI suite. They make the custom stuff a lot easier as well. So let me know in the comments what you think or if you have a different perspective, but those are the top three: Storyline 360, ChatGPT, and FreePik. You're going to be in very good shape if you're very strong with those three tools. The big runner-ups, I would say, the first one is Rise 360. You may have heard of this one, especially if you've heard of Storyline 360. This is what it looks like. This is like the editor view. So you could tell very different than the Storyline one where it's like a blank canvas and you just add anything you want to it. This is one of their templates. You could like add... You can add content here, we can edit content, and it's very modular, right? So we have like a quote block here, we can edit the content over here, change out the images, we can add a new content section here, and it's very, you know, there are limited options what we can add. We can add these different statements that look like that, different quote blocks. We can add images with different layout options. So it's much easier to build something in here that looks very polished and professional because, you know, the designers have already given us these options, prepared these options for us, but it's not as custom, of course. It's more limited. There are certain tools you can use to extend the capabilities of Rise 360. And if you want me to create a video on that, just let me know. But yeah, this isn't as impressive in a portfolio site, but it can make for a really good supporting project. If you have like a Storyline 360 main flagship project and then show off some Rise 360 skills as well, these are good for like fast courses that are more info heavy, whereas Storyline 360 is much better for like gamified experiences and things like that. And you can embed Storyline 360 e-learning inside of a block in like a Rise 360 course. So we could actually add, Storyline 360 experience here as well. So they work together decently well, but Storyline 360 is definitely the one that's more in demand. Vyond is a good one. You can create these kind of animated videos. I'm sure you've seen this art style before. Makes for some really good portfolio projects, again, because they give you a ton of assets that you can use. So pretty much any kind of asset you need, you can find in their style. And then it's a browser-based video editing tool. So you can edit everything quite easily as well, add all the animation you need, that good stuff. So a very popular tool with instructional designers. Figma is really good for creating mockups and layouts. Like, you know, rarely are you going to want to go into Storyline and just start adding shapes and trying to design everything in there. It's going to be much more clunky than if you use a tool like Figma. That's where you want to like lay out like where your different user interface elements are going and what your question slides will look like, what your title slide will look like. It's much easier to do that in a tool like Figma before going into Storyline. You want to get the visual design polished before you actually start adding that interactivity. And then I would just say any video editing tool, like Storyline can do some basic video editing, but you'll have a much better time in a dedicated one. So Premiere Pro, Final Cut Pro, Camtasia, these are all valid video editors. Any learning management system will help too, especially because new IDs can be quite intimidated by learning management systems, but it's really not super complicated. I have a video about how to use, I think, Talent LMS on the channel. Just learn how to upload one of your e-learning courses to it, right? You can create something in Storyline 360, publish it as a scoring package, and then upload it to a learning management system and like enroll yourself, you know, enroll your own email address. That will give you 50% at least of what you need to know when you're working in an LMS. And then Adobe Illustrator as well. If you want to be able to edit these vector graphics and like change the colors of them or just take out like, you know, this wave or one of these, you know, creatures, you can do that with Illustrator. You can edit vector images very, or vector graphics very precisely with a tool like Illustrator. So those are the runner-ups. I will say though, don't stress about learning every tool right away. I definitely overdid it. I think most people kind of go too deep into the tools when they're getting into the field. You just need enough to create some solid portfolio projects. You can go very far with just knowing Storyline 360, right? If you were going to master a single tool, that is definitely the one to master. And then you'll develop these supplemental tech skills as you go, as well. So yeah, don't feel like you need to learn every single one of these tools I mentioned to a super high degree before you can become an ID or something like that. But if you are becoming an instructional designer, you can check out my updated guide. I published it a few weeks ago. I will link it in the comments beneath this video. I hope that this was helpful. Let me know if there's anything else I can do, and I'll see you in the next video.